you all to my channel. Is this your first time of coming to my channel? Thanks a lot. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, share and subscribe. So in this tutorial we are going to making a simple video on how to cut and sew your pleated maxi skirts with slits. So this tutorial is going to enable you to know how to achieve your maxi skirts and also how to achieve your slits. So basically for this style you can make use of any fabric of your choice: African print, crepe, chiffon, cotton fabric. You can actually use any fabric of your choice. So if you have any question in the course of this tutorial, please go ahead and drop your questions in the comment section or any topic you want us to make a video on. So what are the basic measurements required in order for you to achieve your pleated skirt with slits? Your waist measurements, hip measurements and your skirt length. So our skirt length is basically from our waist to our desired length. Okay, now we have 46 inches for our skirt length, so let's go ahead now and calculate our measurements. So our waist is 32 divided by 4 plus 2, we have 10 inches. Our hip is 40 inches, 40 divided by 4 plus 2, we have 12 inches. Our skirt length is 46 inches. Now note that our band, note that your skirt is going to have a band. So the inches you need for your band totally depends on you. You can make use of a very tiny band of 2 inches, you can make use of 4 inches band, 3 inches band. It all depends on how big you want your band to be. So go ahead and decide that. So me, I'm going to make use of 2 inches, and note that this is optional. You can use, you know, 3 inches for your band, 4 inches. It all depends on you, right? So let's go ahead now and deduct 2 inches for our band from our skirt length. I'm going to have my band. My band is 2 inches, my skirt length is 46 minus 2 inches for my band, I'm going to have 44 inches. Now for your band of 2 inches, you go ahead and add 1 inch for your sewing allowance, you have 3 inches. Our skirt length is 46 minus 2 inches for your band, you have 44, plus 2 inches for sewing allowance, you have 46 inches, right? So basically this is what you need for your measurements. Now the other thing you also need to take note of is what is the amount of fabric you need to pleat or to gather up your maxi skirt. Basically all you have to do is to multiply your hip measurement by 3, or you multiply your hip measurement by 2.5. now what will you consider to know if you want to multiply your hip measurement by 3 or you want to multiply your hip measurement by 2.5? now if you want your maxi skirt to be very full, all you have to do basically is to multiply your hip measurement by 3, and it also depends on the amount of fabric you are working with and also how full you want your maxi dress to be. However, you can also multiply your hip measurement by 2.5. If you want your pleating to be too full, you can multiply your hip measurement by 2.5, and also it also depends on the amount of fabric you are working with. I'm going to go ahead and put the detailed tutorial on how to make use of your ruffler foot to gather up your pleat. I'll go ahead and put the link here. Please go ahead and watch the tutorial on how to make use of gathered foot to achieve your pleat. So now our hip measurement is 40 inches. I'm going to multiply my hip measurement by 3. So let's go ahead now and calculate that. Measurement now is 40. I think it's better there. So my hip measurement now is 40 inches multiplied by 3. I have 120 inches, right? So it simply means that the amount of fabric I need for the width is 120 inches, and for the length I need 46 inches for the length of the skirt, and for the width I'm going to make use of 120 inches. Now note that the 120 inches is for the fabric you need to pleat on your band. While the length of your band basically is just your waist measurement plus your sewing allowance. So I'm going to explain all of that in detail once we get to the cutting part of this tutorial. And don't forget to join us on Facebook, TG Designs, on Instagram, TG Designs, and also visit our website. We have amazing fashion illustration on our website. All the details are going to be in the description box below. So guys, now we want to cut out the pleated skirt with slits. Okay, so this form of skirt, now we are going to have slits. Now we are going to be rocking our off shoulder top. I'm going to go ahead and put the link here. Please go ahead and check out how we're able to achieve the off shoulder top with elastic that we are rocking on this skirt. So I'm going to put the link here. Please go ahead now and watch that after checking out this video. So what are the measurements required now? So we've gone ahead to say that, you know, to know the amount of fabric you need for this skirt, go ahead and multiply your hip measurement by 3 or by 2.5. It really depends on the amount of fabric you are working with and also how full your fabric is. So if your hip measurement now is 40 inches, 40 multiplied by 3, we have 120 inches. It means that, you know, for the width this way, I have, don't forget that I folded it into two, as you can see. So for the width this way, I have 120 inches for my width, because that is my hip measurement divided multiplied by 3. Now for the length of this skirt, I'm making use of the old length of this African print, which is 45 inches, because that's just my skirt length. But it depends on you. You can, you know, just go ahead and measure your skirt length to your desired length. But for the width, you're basically just going to multiply your hip measurement by 3. So it's actually very simple. The next thing you just need to cut now is your band. So basically you need your band, and this is what I have for my band. The wideness of my band, I have 6 inches for the wideness of my band folded into 2. I have 8 inches rather. So folded into 2 this way, I'm going to have 4 inches because I want this to be a big band. You can see, so just have, you can see, like, you can have an idea of what it's gonna look like. So now when I fold this into 2, I'm gonna have 4 inches. After stitching my 1 inch, you know, sewing allowance to this skirt, I'm gonna have about 3 inches. So for the length of your band, basically your waist measurement plus 2. So my waist measurement is 32 inches plus 2 inches, I have 34. 2 inches is my sewing allowance. So for the length this way, I have 34 inches by 8 for this. Now, I don't know if you guys know that this is a line fabric. When you place your line straight this way, it makes the person look taller. So you should also take note of that. When you place your fabric this way, it makes the person look taller. But when you place your fabric this way, it makes the person look fatter. So for skirts, you know, it's advisable you place it this way straight so that the person can look taller than, you know, the person's length, right? So, but if it's a blouse and you want the person to look fatter, you can go ahead and, you know, turn it this way so that you can have this line coming this way. But if you want the person to look taller, you just play. Now for the band, I've gone ahead to iron the paper stay just to give it like form of structure. That's basically the essence of this paper stay. So the next thing I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and gather this fabric on the band. I'll just go ahead and gather this fabric. And don't forget that this fabric, I have about 120 inches, which is your hip measurement multiplied by 3. So I'll just go ahead now and gather this up. You can make use of your gather's foot. I have a detailed tutorial on how to make use of gather's foot. I'm going to put the link here. Please go ahead and watch that. So once I'm done, I'll show you guys what it looks like. So guys, now I've gone ahead to couple this up, you know, to the band, and this is what it looks like. So I'll be rocking this with a off-shoulder pleated top, off-shoulder top with elastic. I'm going to go ahead and put the link here. Please go ahead and check out how we're able to achieve this, achieve the top. So this is what it looks like, and I've gone ahead now to, you know, just basically couple this up, fixing my zipper, and then stitch it all the way around. So the next thing we want to do now is to get our slit. Okay, is to get our slit. So first thing first is straighten your fabric. Make sure your fabric is straight enough right? Make sure your fabric is straight enough. So this is what we have. So because I am making use of a straps fabric, it will be easy for me to, like, you know, just cut it out without using chalk. But make sure you use chalk if you are not working with straps fabric like this. So your zip point is always like the midpoint of the front block. So you place your tape measure at this band now and go ahead and determine where do you want your slit to be. Is it at the right hand side or at the left hand side? Once you are done with that, you go ahead and mark your dart measurement. So my dart measurement now is 4 inches. 4 inches falls across this line, right? Across this line. Like I said, go ahead and chalk this. So I'll just go ahead now and open this up. Now the length of your sleeves totally depends on how high you want it to go. So this is just your choice. Basically, you can take it high, you can reduce it. It all depends on you at the end of the day. So I've gone ahead now to open up the sleeves. I'm just going to go ahead and hem the sleeves, and our maxi skirt is ready. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give this video a thumbs up, like, share and subscribe. Don't forget to watch the video on how we were able to achieve the blouse, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.